Okay, so Monica ji, so you would be discussing China's chart today, right? In relation to the ongoing condition, you know, the pandemic we are facing, which is related to COVID-19. So can you just brief us about China's chart on this?
Yeah, definitely. Namaskar, greeting to all the viewers and to
Namaskar.
Gaurav ji, Jaya ji.
Namaskar.
The whole world is seriously wondering what exactly has happened. We are all reeling under the shock of coronavirus, and there are a lot of questions that have come up regarding the origin of the virus, how
Yes.
exactly this virus had started, and there are a lot of theories about it. So today I would be actually looking at China's chart to analyze and visualize how exactly this virus would have started.
Okay.
So I would start with the birth chart of China. So this is 1st October 1949. So if you see, Capricorn Lagna is rising and
Right.
Lagna lord has gone to the 8th house. So that is the house of secrecy and deception where Saturn is there. Moon in the Lagna is a very, very good indication, because whenever the Lagna and Moon is combined, then there is a positive direction, and you know, the mind and body all work together towards a goal.
Yeah, okay, so basically they are aligned.
They're absolutely aligned.
Okay.
So they're able to implement their thoughts and actions very fast.
Okay.
Now the other good point is the 10th Lord Venus is in own house. Jupiter is also in own house. It is the 12th Lord and the 3rd Lord. The 11th house is something I would want you to look at very carefully, because that is the house of my desires, my gains, my greeds. Now
Okay.
here the 11th Lord has debilitated. It's gone to the 7th house, and from here it is directly connecting to Lagna and Moon both. So
Okay.
my desires are going to be controlling my actions to a large extent. And that is also very clear from the fact that we know that China actually very justifiably wants a place for themselves in the world. They want to be recognized as a force. So
Yeah.
that's very clearly coming from the horoscope.
Yeah. And it's a very strong Chandra Mangal Yoga also, if we see in the chart.
Absolutely. Yes. Yes,
Because
you're right.
Mars is the 11th Lord and it is connecting the Moon in the Lagna, which is the 7th Lord. So probably they are making a lot of money from 7th houses like your partners.
Yes, and the second house also comes here.
Yeah.
So money, certainly, certainly, that's right. Now I would want you to look at the 9th house.
Yeah.
9th Lord Mercury is exalted in the 9th house, which is very good. However, if you see carefully, you would find that Mercury is retrograde. It is combust. It is also hemmed between two malefics, Ketu and Sun.
Yeah,
In
definitely.
addition to that, it's also at a very close degree with Ketu.
Right.
So this is something that I'm going to be coming back again. So this is one point that you know we must look at. So now, if you see, China has been running the dasha of Saturn for last 19 years, and during the 19 years they have, you know, Saturn symbolizes people, so it's the people who have worked very hard. You see, Saturn is also connected to the 10th house and
Yes.
second house of wealth. So
Right.
it's basically the blue collar jobs that Saturn represents. That is what China has been doing. A lot of manufacturing and you know low paid jobs that they have taken over, and they are actually the ones who have brought the economic might of China to a great extent, also resultantly its military might and the wealth. So
Yeah.
Saturn dasha has brought all that into action. However, during the closing of Saturn dasha, things have not been as well, because it is the first time in decades that we saw that the economic growth of China had slowed. Otherwise, for decades it saw, you know, a 10% growth per annum, GDP growth for
Yeah.
years.
Bilkul.
So this
Maybe I
was
think it was Dasha Chhidra for them, and that was Saturn Jupiter period. So
precisely,
probably
precisely,
that's the
precisely.
reason this happened.
Yes, actually, when I'll be talking about the dasha pravesh of Mercury, that is when you know the results would manifest. And of course, the results start coming from the dasha pravesh itself.
So can you show Vimshottari Dasha? Because you know, if we see the chart, you are showing Char Dasha right now. So if for our viewers, please show Vimshottari Dasha so that you know they are able to see when actually Mercury Dasha is starting. Yeah,
Yeah,
okay, that's
that's
good.
good. So you can see here. So now, if you see, Mercury Mahadasha has started from 24th of September 2019,
Right.
and dasha is the one that gives direction to the country, to the nation, and it's going to be a 17-year dasha. Now, Mercury by temperament is very, very different from Saturn. Mercury is mind. Mercury is mind. Mercury is intellect. Here, if you look at Mercury again, you will find Mercury conjunct with Ketu. Mercury conjunct with the 8th Lord Sun. This is the Mahadasha that has come. And this is the Mahadasha which is going to be giving results.
Oh, so basically it is representing change because of connection with the 8th Lord?
Yes. It is representing change because of 8th Lord, and Ketu is in itself a very deceptive and inward looking planet.
Right.
Ketu is also, I would like to point out, is a bacteria, the virus.
Hmm.
We are talking about coronavirus, which has just happened at the start of Mercury Dasha.
Yeah,
Mercury,
so basically Mercury is a 6th Lord also, and it is connected with Ketu and the 8th Lord. So, and the Mercury, if I see from the Vimshottari Dasha, it starts from 24th of September. So probably this virus, it started in October or November. Actually, nobody knows, you know, because China, they don't reveal what exactly is happening in their country because media is controlled by the state.
Yes.
So we don't know for sure that when actually it started. In November, right? Or December. I don't remember the dates.
Actually, it had started in November, but December was the time when all the doctors and all noticed it for the first time.
Okay.
When I talk about the Mercury Dasha Pravesh, things would be a lot clearer.
Okay.
Okay. So we have seen that this is the tendencies of the latent natal chart Mercury. Now, if we go to the Dasha Pravesh chart. So I have just put in the Mercury Dasha Pravesh chart now.
Okay.
First, let me just tell you that a Dasha Pravesh chart is nothing but the transit position of planets on the very day when the new Mahadasha starts.
Okay, like so just, you know, for our viewers, just tell us, I mean, how do you calculate the Dasha Pravesh chart? Do you take the same Lagna or we calculate the Lagna at the precise time? I mean, how does it work?
We take the Lagna of at the ascendant chart and at the exact degree of the ascendant chart.
Okay.
So here, if you see, my ascendant is 1247. So China's ascendant would also be 1247.
Okay. So you take that time on the day Dasha is starting. So we take the same degrees of the ascendant. This is what you mean, right?
Yes. Oh. Precisely. Okay. So the moment we look at the Mercury Mahadasha chart, a lot of things start becoming clearer. Firstly, let's look at the ascendant. Ascendant Lord Saturn has gone to the 12th house. Mm-hmm. It is in degree conjunction with Ketu, the virus that we were talking about.
Okay.
So that role comes very clear. And there is a Gulik also, which is there.
Mm.
Then the 7th house of war, which I'll say 7th house, which is my public relations, my public image of war, all those things. The 7th Lord is in its own house and it is flanked by two malefics.
Oh, so basically it is in Pap Kartri again here.
It is in Pap Kartri, that's right. So that is one thing that that is coming very well. The third thing is that the Mahadasha Lord Mercury, if you see, it is actually in, it's transiting in the 9th house and you would find it's actually in degree, near very, very degree to the Ketu of natal chart.
Oh, okay.
So this Mercury of transit, Dasha Pravesh, is actually transiting over Ketu. So plus Mercury is also at close degree. So that manifestation is going to come.
No, but like you see, if we see this Mercury, it is connected with the 10th Lord Venus also here and the 8th Lord Sun. So, is it a good Dasha which they are going to have or what? Because for this chart, this Mercury for we see, it is a good Mercury being in its own sign. And being placed with the 10th Lord. I know 8th Lord is also there, but would it give good results also for them?
It is going to be giving mixed results.
Okay.
Gaurav, yahan pe aap dekho, to yahan pe Saturn jo hai, wo bhi aspect kar raha hai.
Haan, that I can see, yes, definitely.
Aur Mercury exalted hai, no doubt, par 8th Lord ke saath mein hai.
Okay. So basically, like you know what Monica is saying, it would give mixed results. That means,
if you see the why exactly COVID started, that is very, very visible here.
Okay.
So
what you need to see here is what I was coming at is Mercury at close degree with Ketu of natal Sun.
Yes.
Mercury and Sun both are transiting over their natal positions, so their significations are going to be considerably enhanced.
Okay.
Mercury is the 6th Lord. Sun is the 8th Lord. So that is the significations which has come here. 10th Lord has debilitated. It has come to the 9th house.
Yes.
So here the debilitated actions of 10th Lord is very clearly visible. Now, so what exactly
we can say that, you know, their own actions has resulted into this situation. Can we say that?
We can say that, especially when we look at Saturn aspecting this combination. Saturn is junked with Ketu.
Theories are going on.
Gaurav, main yahan pe ek do cheez aur bolna chahungi.
And even, you know, if you read online that, you know, probably they created this virus or something. So can we say that their own actions has resulted into this situation?
Absolutely right, because Sun here is research, 8th house is research. 8th house is also laboratory. So combination of Sun with Mercury Mahadasha with debilitated 10th Lord, aspected by Lagna Lord, who's actually degree conjunction with Ketu. So the inception of the chart is very, very clearly visible.
So basically it indicates, you know, something fishy had happened.
Gaurav, main kuch cheeze yahan pe aur add karna chahungi. Yahan pe dekho to 7th jo house hai, और वहाँ पे 7th लॉर्ड मून भी बैठा हुआ है और वो पाप कर्तरी में 7th हाउस जहाँ पर देखे तो ये रिप्रेजेंट करता है फॉरेन कंट्री के साथ हमारे रिलेशनशिप को, जो कि यहाँ पर ये ब्लॉक कर रहा है 17 ईयर के लिए चाइना के.
हाँ, तो बेसिकली इनके जो फॉरेन कंट्रीज के साथ रिलेशंस है, जिसकी वजह से इनकी नेटल चार्ट के अंदर इफ वी सी दैट दे हैव दिस चंद्र मंगल योग एंड दे आर मेकिंग मनी आउट ऑफ इट, तो
प्लीज मोनिका आप वो चार्ट लगा दो.
शोइंग दैट इट इज बीइंग ब्लॉक्ड, राइट? दिस इज व्हाट यू आर ट्राइंग टू से.
यस, बिल्कुल. यस, यस, दैट्स राइट.
मोनिका, आप प्लीज नेटल चार्ट लगा दें.
ये नेटल चार्ट में अगर आप देखें तो ये केतु है, ये आप डिग्री देख रहे हैं, मकरी अभी इसी के ऊपर ट्रांसिट कर रहा है.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल
जी, बिल्कुल.
एंड देन अगेन, यू नो, द सन इज शोइंग द रिसेप्शन व्हिच इज देयर एंड लेबोरेटरी.
ओके
मोनिका, आपको याद है जब हम लोग गुरुजी के साथ क्लास में डिस्कस कर रहे थे, तो गुरुजी ने ये बोला था कि अभी जो इनका जो 17 से जब इनकी दशा शुरू हो रही है, छिद्र दशा सैटर्न जुपिटर, और वो उस समय जो हमारा ट्रांजिट का पोजिशन था वो धनु राशि पर ही सैटर्न की मूवमेंट थी और जुपिटर की मूवमेंट थी, और इसके अलावा जो वहाँ पे अष्टक वर्ग के जो पॉइंट है वो बहुत कम है. ठीक, तो इस समय सर ने हमको यही
कहेंगे. मोनिका जी, इनका
तो
इसी में ये रहा नीचे, राइट, ये रहा.
यस
सर.
यस, हाँ, ये
ठीक है.
आप देख पा रहे हैं इसको?
नहीं, अभी तो आया नहीं है.
मुझे तो दिख नहीं रहा है. गौरव जी आ रहे बस. ठीक है,
नहीं है, एक मिनट रुकिए.
इसको लगन चार्ट का,
मुझे इसको लगन का करना है.
हाँ, इसको लगन का करके ना, हाँ, चार्ट को लगन का कर दीजिए, फिर दिखेगा.
हाँ,
नहीं, पहले उसको लगन चार्ट कीजिए आप, उसके बाद दिखेगा.
ये नवांस नवांस का आ रहा है
पहले ना.
आप ओके, नहीं, आप एक सेकंड.
जन्म का बना है, जन्म गलत हो रहा है. चार्ट डिग्री बर्थ,
ये एक्चुअली मैं जहाँ पे हूँ वहाँ पे ये आई थिंक मैं चेंज नहीं कर सकती, क्योंकि
कोई बात नहीं, हम लोग ऐसे ओरली डिस्कस कर रहे हैं.
जस्ट कंटिन्यू.
ओके, श्योर.
यहाँ पे मोनिका, आपको याद होगा हम लोगों ने क्लास में ये चीज डिस्कस करी थी गुरुजी के साथ में, जब अष्टक वर्ग के पॉइंट 12th हाउस में बहुत कम है और वहां पर जब ट्रांजिट का सैटर्न चल रहा है, पास हो रहा था वहां से, तो उनकी इकोनॉमी जो 2017 से बहुत स्लो डाउन चली गई थी, और ये कहा जा रहा था कि उसके बाद चीजें बेटर होंगी.
यस, कितने 19 पॉइंट्स है, राइट? 19 पॉइंट्स है, आप
देख सकते हैं यहां पे. 19 पॉइंट्स,
या या, नाउ वी कैन सी.
ओके, सो
यहां पर सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज यहां पे ये है मोनिका, कि इसके बाद जो दशा आ रही है, ठीक, जिसकी वजह से ये शायद चाइना ये समझ रहा था कि वो पूरे वर्ल्ड पे रूल करेगा या उसका जो प्लान है, यहाँ पे मुझे उसमें थोड़ा डाउट लग रहा है. यहाँ पे आपका क्या कहना है?
आपका बिल्कुल सही कहना है. इसके अलावा जैसे मैंने गौरव जी को बोला कि मिक्स रिजल्ट्स आएंगे. अगर आप षडबल
में तो देखिए यहाँ मोनिका जी, जया जी, ये तो बड़ा क्लियर दिख रहा है कि मरकरी मरकरी और मरकरी केतु इनके लिए इतना अच्छा नहीं दिख रहा है.
नहीं सर, ये मरकरी का आप
अगर, सो यू नो, थिंग्स ओनली स्टार्ट इंप्रूविंग फॉर देम फ्रॉम व्हेन मरकरी वीनस स्टार्ट्स.
गौरव यहाँ पर आप कष्टकबर्ग के पॉइंट्स देखेंगे तो नाइन्थ हाउस में जहाँ मर्करी प्लेस है उस पर ध्यान दें तो वहां पर 22 पॉइंट्स है।
yes.
तो 25 से अगर कम पॉइंट्स होते हैं तो वहां पर ऑलरेडी बहुत अच्छा रिजल्ट
हुआ। आई सॉ दैट यू नो बेसिकली आई वाज फोकसिंग ऑन वीनस। अगर आप 10th हाउस इनका देखें तो वहां पे बहुत अच्छे पॉइंट्स हैं। सो प्रोबेबली यू नो आई मीन दैट्स माय ओपिनियन दैट वंस मर्करी वीनस स्टार्ट्स थिंग वुड स्टार्ट इंप्रूविंग फॉर देम।
I agree with you. And second thing is कि जो इन्होंने राइज किया है, the entire rise is in Saturn महादशा. That time also points were actually only 25.
Saturn in 8th house is always considered an exception. Plus, in if we see this chart, it is expecting their second house, which is Kumbh Rashi.
Saturn. यहाँ पर गौरव में कुछ और
चीजें हैं. It's aspect on its exaltation sign also the 10th house. It shows that they rose because of the hard work that we can see.
Yes, and another thing I like to point out is if you see the Shatbal points.
Yeah.
Shatbal point is considerably lower than Saturn's. Saturn is 1.59 Mercury is just 1.05. So it is going to go down from its position for sure. That is very clearly visible.
Monica, यहाँ पे ये भी देखें कि जो अभी की जो सिचुएशन है उसमें अभी मैं परसों पढ़ रही थी तो जो ये है ट्रम्प वो बोल रहे थे कि जब वुहान में ये वायरस फैला तो बाकी उन्होंने सारे अपने स्टेट्स को कवर कर लिया ठीक लेकिन अपने जो वो जो बाकी जो कंट्रीज है वहां पर वुहान से लोग आते जाते रहे तो कहीं ना कहीं ये प्लांट वे में तो दिखाई ही दे रहा है
100% क्योंकि वुहान से ये बाहर चाइना में क्यों नहीं फैला हमारे
देखिए यू नो दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन मार्क हियर कि वहां क्यों नहीं फैला बट प्रोबेबली यू नो वी कैनॉट से दिस विद श्योरिटी बिकॉज आप एक चीज देखिए ना लॉट ऑफ न्यूज डजंट कम आउट ऑफ चाइना सो मे बी दे आर हाइडिंग समथिंग दैट यू नो इट डिडंट स्प्रेड इन देयर अदर स्टेट्स और सिटीज बिकॉज यू नो आई वॉज रीडिंग ऑन द इंटरनेट दैट अराउंड 10 मिलियन फोन्स इन चाइना दे हैव गॉन डेड
बिल्कुल
दिस इज अनदर न्यूज एंड यू नो नोबडी हैज एन आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन वेयर व्हाट हैपेंड टू 10 मिलियन फोन्स प्रोबेबली यू नो 10 मिलियन पीपल हैड दोस फोन्स So, again, this is a question mark. We don't know exactly what happened.
Yes. So, what I'll do is, we've seen the natal chart. We have seen the Dasha Pravesh chart of Mercury, which is showing us next 17 years how it's going to be.
Yes. And definitely, you know, your chart, if we see these charts, it is very clear that Mercury and Mercury Ketu periods are not going to be good for them.
Precisely.
And
specifically to the September chart, that is the Varshfal chart.
Okay.
Which will tell us how the September, like the 2019-2020 September, this year is going to be. So if you see this, it started from 2nd of October. Now the Varshfal chart, the Lagna itself shows you very clearly about the whole deception thing. Oh. Lagna is 19 degree in degree conjunction with Ketu and Saturn.
Okay.
This very clearly shows what the government's plans were.
Oh, so this is the chart of 2nd October 2019. Wow.
Yes, it's the Varshfal chart of China.
Okay. So basically, you know, Ketu's position here in Lagna on the same degree.
Yes, so it is showing deception, clear deception here.
Yes.
Plus, if you see the, you know, you have to see the Lagna Lord in 12th house in degree conjunction with Gulik.
Okay.
So plus the 8th Lord has debilitated in the 12th house. So the if this does not point to deception, then what does? So, you know, it is very clearly pointing out the loss, the plan. And if you want to see,
you know, they are hiding, you know, they are holding back, we can say that lot of facts which they are not sharing with the world.
And it is very clear from the 10th house. If you see the 10th house, 10th and 11th house, there is an exchange. 11th Lord debilitated in the 10th house is going to make China's desires, you know, people to act on China's desire. Now, 11th Lord here is with two malefics, Sun and Mars. So it is going to bulldoze and force its way to, you know, implement whatever they have planned, which is very clearly visible from the Lagna, the plan. And 10th house is the implementation of that.
Right.
It's another thing I like to point out here that I'd really like to, you know, share with our users here. You know, Ketu is not only the bacteria and virus. Ketu is also software.
Yes.
So the espionage angle of, you know, all the software that we are using. So there is an increase that's going to happen in corporate espionage on, you know, the kind of policing that people would be forced to, you know, people would be facing. So that's something we need to be upfront, very, very careful about.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल so बहुत बहुत ज्यादा ध्यान रखने की जरूरत है.
यू कैन से दे कैन प्लान, दे आर प्लानिंग सॉफ्टवेयर बेसिकली साइबर अटैक्स एंड ऑल.
यस yes exactly, yes so exactly. It has already, words are floating around and it is showing that it is actually true.
Yeah, because you know, if we read the news also, like, you know, even Indian government, they were saying not to use Zoom, which is a Chinese app, because yes, probably it is you know, they are basically, you can say, recording all the information.
Yes, yes, yes.
So, so the there is a Home Ministry advisory not to use this app also.
You're right. Zoom app, actually, they have said, you know, we should not
be using. Yeah, there was an advisory by the Home Ministry.
Yes. And another thing is, when, you know, the whole world is reeling under this stock market pressure and all, China is actually going ahead and buying the assets of those companies who share
prices. They are investing in other countries.
So that is the tendencies of Mercury with Ketu, you know, the Mahadasha Lord. So all those things about economic activities, all that would be increasing tenfold now. This is just the start. This is not the last virus that has been released. This is not the last time an espionage has happened. But these things are going to be increasing multifold. We need to be looking at ways to protect ourselves.
Okay. Yeah, this is an eye opener, actually. You know, people should actually think on these lines. I mean, it's a great thing which you had shared with our viewers here.
Gaurav, I would also like to say here that, you know, as Shri Krishna had said in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, that you always reap what you sow.
Yeah.
So, you know, Krishna's Bansuri is going to play and there are going to be repercussions. So what I'll say is that, you know, you're so rightly, you also mentioned that, you know, the Mercury, Ketu, Dasha, they stand exposed before the world.
Yes.
So there are going to be repercussions. There are going to be economic sanctions. That's very, very clearly visible.
Mm-hmm.
And I would say here that to all the viewers as well, that, you know, let's look at our actions, you know, let's remember that all actions has a equal and positive and, you know, opposite reaction. So let's look at our karmas as well.
All right.